Hello, it's Patrick here from thegarageBandguide.com. In this video, I'll show you how to get started with GarageBand Sampler. To open the sampler, you'll need to open a software instrument track. I'll click the new track icon and select Software Instrument here. Get rid of the library pane and open the Smart Controls window. With the Tracks tab selected, go down to the Plugins menu and click on the currently loaded software instrument to open the menu. Hover over Audio Unit Instruments, then Apple, and then over Audio Unit Sampler before finally clicking Stereo. This is the sampler interface, and while it's easy to be intimidated by all of its controls, don't worry as it's actually really simple to set up. Hitting any note here will trigger a default sine wave sound. ...99% of the time you'll want to remove this sound from your recordings, so you will want to get rid of it, but first let's load up our sample. I'm going to pick a sample from a free sample pack I downloaded from lander.com, that's the online mastering service, but you can use sounds that you've perhaps purchased previously, downloaded from another website, or even created yourself in GarageBand. I'll put a link to the sample pack that I'm using in this video in the description. Click on this small cog icon at the bottom of the sampler window and select Add Samples. You can then choose where you want to load your samples in from. I have the pack that I downloaded saved to my desktop.
This is where I am, and not anymore.
This one sounds good to me, so I'll load it up into the sampler.
This is where I am.
Now, the sample I've loaded plays alongside the default sine wave sound, as they're both active at the same time. To remove the sine wave sound, select it and then click on the minus button at the bottom of the sampler window. Now the sample plays on its own. Now it's just a case of adding your sample to your project. Treat this the same as you would any normal software instrument. Just hit record and start playing when ready. And let's listen to that back with the rest of the project. It's maybe a bit out of time, so I'll quantize the notes using the quantize function in the editor window. I need to make sure that I quantize the whole track, not just that one region. It's almost there, it's almost there. I'll have to edit these notes slightly as a couple haven't triggered when I've played them, or they've cut off too early. You can also add third-party instruments and sounds into the sampler. They need to be in either DLS or EXS file formats to do this. Luckily, both types are readily available. Click on this cog icon at the top of the sample window and select the file type that you want to load. Select the file to load. Again, I have this one saved to my desktop. And, right, I've made a bit of a mistake here. You need to create a new layer in the sampler by clicking the plus icon at the bottom of the window and then load your new instrument into it. There we go, you can now play the contents of that file inside GarageBand's sampler. There you have it. That's everything you need to get started with the sampler in GarageBand. If you found this video helpful, subscribe to the channel if you want to see more videos like this one. And don't forget to hit the notification bell to make sure you don't miss a thing. I've been Patrick from thegarageBandguide.com, and I'll see you next time. Bye for now.